if you want to have credibility, you can do it in two ways. You can get write a book, which is gives you instant credibility. Even if it's a bad book, people will say, well, this guy's an expert,
right?
He's got a book, right?
So you can just go to a church, for instance, and speak if you have a book. And
sure. Yeah, they're going to say, this guy's a book, must be somebody.
Yeah.
Right? Even though he could be a complete doofus. So.
All right. Well, let's talk a little about your book, Stealing from God, right? Why don't you want to hold that up?
I want to hold this book?
Yeah, hold it up
this
for
the Capturing the Christianity
by
broadcast
this book.
Is brought to you by Stealing from God. Why atheists need God to make their case. How's that? Is that good?
That's great.
All right, beautiful.
That's great. Is the Bible compatible with evolution, meaning common ancestry is true, but the process was guided?
Well, it depends on what you mean by that. If you mean biblical inerrancy, it doesn't appear to be compatible because you've got God creating Adam out of the dust, not out of pre-existing animal forms. So I would say no.
All I'm wanting to do is explain what the Bible actually says in its actual language, and that is that God the Creator made a big structure with multiple layers to it. And on day one, he made all the layers above where we live. And on day two, he made the roof over our layer that encapsulates us and what we call the earth.
Is that what you're saying? We'd have to reject biblical inerrancy in
order
to adopt?
Well, yeah, if we're going to say, or unless we're just going to allegorize the whole thing and say okay. when Genesis says that God created Adam out of the dust, that was just a metaphor of some kind.
Of what the word heaven is, and it's literally a solid structure. It's like a roof over us. And there's multiple layers of that, of the structure called a firmament that was made on day one and then refashioned into another layer directly above where we live on day two.
So well, it wouldn't reject inerrancy or even inspiration. It would just be, this is a different interpretation of this biblical passage.
Right. I think you can do that with some passages. That one seems pretty clear to me.
Which
though.
One?
That God creates Adam out of the dust. He doesn't create him out of pre-existing life forms.
Mm-hmm.
He seems to directly, divinely create Adam out of dust. So all the other animals are created and then you get man. So
yeah. Well, some,
it would
some
seem
people,
to be an odd interpretation to say that we could fit evolution in there.
Yes.
And the literal stars, like in Genesis 1:14-17, that were placed in the layers of the firmament over us to give lights and signs and seasons, that they're literally going to fall to the ground at his return because he opened up the container that they were in.
It would seem to be an odd interpretation.
Just how old is our planet? Scientists believe it's
hundreds and hundreds of years old.
Scientists have determined that the universe was created by
God.
Big Bang.